I have a lot to talk about, and I don't really want to go back to edit, so we'll see how this goes if I don't screw it up. And last night, yesterday, I threw the whole ketogenic thing out the window. And it's partly because of my living situation. I don't have my own kitchen, even though I have all my own kitchen stuff in boxes, so I can't be organized with all my glass containers and having everything and having space to lay everything out and see things visually and what I'm doing. And I have to go upstairs to use the kitchen, and my dishes, some of them are down here, and my food, some is down, some is up, and I'm going back and forth and back and forth. And yesterday I didn't have a ripe avocado, and I was just like, this is nuts. I can't do this. I can't be in conflict with my surroundings. So then I ate a couple of Laura bars and some dates and lots of sugary stuff. Plus the other thing was, I was really, really tired, and I think it's partly because I did the high intensity interval training on my elliptical, and I don't know if I'm cut out for that. I think it really wipes me out. I could just be making excuses here, but I decided I'm gonna go with the flow when it comes to food. When I have my own space and I'm settled, maybe I'll do some kind of thing like that. I used to be really good at sticking with things like dietary changes when I had my own space, and that was my main thing I was doing, was taking care of myself, but I don't really have that, so I think I'm gonna go with like more packaged stuff and just things I don't even have to do dishes, because it's so complicated and confusing to do right now for me. So yeah, scrap that. And then I felt terrible last night, and I almost started watching Amazon Prime, but instead I watched some interesting things on YouTube. And also, I felt so terrible, and this morning I felt kind of blah. Went for Easter lunch with family and stuff, and I was feeling like, oh, I just can't live here and stuff. And then I came back home, and I wasn't sure what I was gonna do. I didn't feel great or anything, and boom, I got into this crazy flow state by going through my email, because that was something on my to-do list. But I just realized, okay, I need to go through my email, because when I was in California, I wasn't really paying attention. Though I do remember there were things that I needed to tend to in my email, and I thought, well, I'll do them when I get back. So I went through my email to the best that I could. There's still tons of backup and stuff, but I went through the last while, and it put me in this flow, and I got like really organized, and I was listening to music. And I think part of the flow trigger was I had my sad light on, my Verilux sad light, not my blue light, because that would have been too intense, but I had that going. I was listening to my music with headphones, and I just had my whole iTunes playlist of however many songs on random, and was just really flowing with that. And I got really organized, and I was getting things organized on paper on my desk, and then my brain twin called me. And usually he texts and say, hey, when do you want to talk? But he just called, and we talked for like an hour and a half, and we came up with this cool process that we're gonna try. He's a little bit in a funk, so I'm gonna send him like inspirational stuff, and maybe he'll comment on it and organize it, and we might turn it into a blog of some kind, and we'll see what happens. I feel pretty inspired by it. It's like he needs a bit of like help and coaching to get out of this funk, and I'm not really one to give suggestions or say do this or that or try this or have you tried that or do you want to try this. I'm more about listening. And so we sort of decided, okay, I'm going to send you some stuff to check out, and maybe you like it, maybe you don't, whatever. So we'll see how that process goes. And we talked about a lot more than that, but it's interesting how I'm like totally high right now after feeling like crap yesterday evening. And I thought, well, I'm not a rapid cycler. I'm more of a steady, like once I'm going on the upswing, then I'm more on the upswing. My eye looks really off center right now. It's like I'm looking at it and it's looking way over. So I don't know if that's part of it, but whatever. It's okay if my eye looks off center. My whole face is kind of warped anyway. But yeah, this morning I took a tyrosine as well as a DL phenylalanine, which is similar to the effect of tyrosine because I was feeling like crap. Plus I didn't take Skullcap and I took 2 Bacopa. And I didn't take holy basil or hawthorn, which are more like downers. And I only took 2 taurine instead of 3. So I was thinking, well, I'm doing this thing with the vitamins where I'm supposed to be navigating my ups and downs, not taking the same thing every single day. So I put that into play today and it did kick in the afternoon. Plus with the music and the light, that probably helped too. So that was cool. And you know, I don't need a ketogenic diet to get into that state. I need more of a flow diet right now. Go with flow, eat what's there, minimize dishes and thinking about preparing and stuff because of my living situation. And so yeah, I'm in total flow, really high. I don't know if I will pay for it tomorrow and feel kind of down. Like I sort of burnt out all this dopamine. I'm not sure if I should be scaling it back, though I do take quite a few things that lower it at night. Plus I sleep in total darkness, so I do have those as backup. Plus I wrote out my crisis steps. I made this chart of what to do to tone down mania, what to do in a crisis, and if I feel suicidal. So I have the sheet. I also have the steps summarized on my wall. So I'm really trying to get it in my head about what I need to do. And so the thing I was thinking of, since I have total darkness set up, since I have all these supplements, can I push it a little bit more? Can I push myself into flow more because I have these ways to bring myself down? And so I'm wondering about that, and I didn't really purposely try to put myself in a really high state today. It just kind of happened. And when I was in that high state, that's when my brain twin called me. So yeah, I changed my blood donation appointment because I signed up for a family constellation workshop. When I was in California, someone told me to try it. So I thought to look it up because I do have some energy with some of my family members that, since I'm around them a lot more lately, I'd like to be able to resolve it. I don't want to feel this stuff. I don't want to feel annoyed and like I'm not able to flow or whatever, and that's more awful stuff that I was feeling a few months ago. So I want to be able to get through that. So it's only $25 for like a whole day. So yeah, I'm kind of excited about that. That's on Saturday. And yeah, also I'm going to go and buy a tennis racket and some cross trainer shoes so I can start to play tennis and do some outdoor things. You know, I whine about where I'm living, but there are fun things around here too. So I need to explore that, I think. And also, I think I talked about already that it's not about having a vision, but it's about being able to see. And then I remember one day before talking about the verb to peer, to be able to see deeply, to be able to see deeper and deeper. And that's what's needed. And being able to see this one consciousness, the fact that it's one consciousness, and maybe talking about that more. I don't want to repeat the old, like go into this whole analogy of peer and to peer and being a peer and blah, blah, blah. So that's that. And I watched The Solar Revolution, made some notes. And I think I already talked about this, how they said tranquilizers only allow the strongest stimuli to reach our conscious perception. And it would be nice if I could not take the tranquilizers and be so sensitive and that be okay. Maybe one day. And obviously the insights and the energy is coming back, and maybe I can let it go for the next month, but perhaps I should start slowing it down on May 1st. Maybe even now, I don't know, we'll see. And I remember last night when I was falling asleep, this is the thing sometimes that happens when I run out of energy, is that I can remote view. Like I'm sleeping, but it feels like I'm have my face in the water. The sensation of being able to see a different world, like looking over here and looking over there, like looking into this totally different world and seeing different scenes, like people eating or someone's face, just such very clear, obvious things. And I'm like looking right at them, but I'm in bed with my eyes closed. It's like when my eyes are closed, these other eyes open and I can see other places. And I could see it when I got up, when I woke up too. Maybe too, because I'm in the total darkness. I'm not sure, but it didn't do anything freaky last night. It just sort of looked around, which was cool. And so yeah, being able to speed up or slow down and playing with that a little more since I do have that in place. And I don't even know if this stuff is speeding me up or slowing me down, because this is the time in my 8.5 month cycle of this up and down and then crisis thing that this would be happening anyway. So I don't think it's causing it. I think it's correlated with it. I do healthier things when I'm in that state and stuff like that. And I do want to share something that they did say in the Solar Revolution movie around the way they describe brain growth. So I'll share that in the next video. And yeah, I'm reached out to Peter Smith. Hopefully he gets back to me, and I have an appointment with him soon to ask him about should I do this whole slowing mania thing down in the beginning of May and see if that sort of prevents hitting a wall of crisis because I've let it accumulate and accumulate. So it seems like I have these like ups and downs, but it's on a generally moving upward trend. And that's the other thing that happened today was somebody that I know says that I look taller. And this person, like many times when I get into higher states, they start saying I look taller, and they've done that many times. So it's sort of like, oh, yeah, I am getting lighter, which if I'm getting lighter, my spine expands and I get a little bit taller for sure. And at some point, I'll share more of that astrology stuff. It's kind of less interesting to me after today because it was such a creative, collaborative day. And I am going to start doing the relaxation audio when I get the Spire, which is that breathing device, and going with that. And I wrote down something about dark matter because I was watching that Solar Revolution movie, but the thing that I want to say about it has nothing to do with what they said in the movie. Dark matter, they say it's like 96% of everything, and the matter we see is only 4%. The dark matter is so things can rearrange, so we keep on living in our own reality. Like the dark matter to me is proof that there's many other realities happening, and we sort of collapse into each reality like puzzle pieces. Like someone might die in one reality but keep on going in the dark matter that others in the visible matter of those people's lives can't see, but they go on in the dark matter with other aspects of some of the same beings or not. I don't know. But I think dark matter has something to do with parallel and other dimensions.